you've got that horse to slow down using a light helmet. Yeah? Right? Technically. So normally that's not the case. Normally you get it to slow down, you have to use a firm, right? Because you ignore it a bit. So you can see where I'm going with that. You can use that to your advantage. Now you wouldn't do it every time, every single jump, but you would just have it in the mix there where the horse basically what's happened is to slow this horse down, you pull on the reins, right? But there are times when you pull on the reins and she doesn't slow down. Right? Is that fair? That's fair to say, right? That's a fair observation. So, really, truly, pulling on the reins doesn't always slow her down. So, what we're trying to do is we're trying to say, okay, is there a way that I can get the horse to listen to me, listen to an aid, and use that to my advantage so I can put that back to when I use the reins, it means slow down instead of some of the time I use the reins, you slow down, some of the time you flat out ignore. So you can actually be clever with that. And there's only so hard you can pull, and there's only such big a bit you can put it in there. Right? If you just keep going down that road, you end up with really strong horses that don't really listen to you, right? So you're trying to find ways to get them to think. So that's one way, utilizing what we did there. Another way would be putting something on the landing side of the jump. There's lots of different ways to get them to think about slowing down without you having to reef on them. The clever part is like how you use it to your advantage. And Nicole. The fence, the circle, back to the flowers, up the middle, use that, through the box, you lead. Try and get a little bit.